First up for you on this morning's Live at 9, 10 million Americans have osteoporosis. It's a disease, of course, that gradually weakens bones and causes 80% of spinal fractures. Left untreated, those fractures can cause the rounded or humped back that you sometimes see in elderly folks.
But Memphis doctors are on the cutting edge of treatment with a procedure that not only fixes the problem, but does it without major surgery or keeping you in a hospital bed. Dr. Jim Bowles with Memphis Vascular Center is here to explain. Doctor, welcome to Live 9. Glad to see
you
here this morning.
Thank you for having me.
This procedure, it has an interesting name. It's called, what, kyphoplasty. What exactly is it?
It rolls right off the tongue, kyphoplasty.
Easy for you to say.
It is essentially, it's a minimally invasive procedure. It's essentially a non-surgical procedure to treat painful compression spinal fractures. And it is used most often to treat seniors with osteoporotic fractures, weakened bones that collapse and cause a significant degree of pain and dysfunction in their lives.
I had no idea that there were so many of these types of fractures. This can be really debilitating.
It's a major cause of debilitation among a wide range of our population. It potentially affects all of us as we age. Statistics out there suggest that 1 in 2 women and 1 in 4 men over the age of 50 will have an osteoporotic fracture in their lifetime.
Doctor, that's a lot of people. Talk to us, though, in layman's terms here about the procedure itself. Is it extremely invasive? Does it take a lot of time? What would we look at here?
The procedure is essentially a one-day procedure. The patient would come in, would undergo about a 30-minute to an hour procedure.
Let me stop you there. Not into the hospital, into the clinic, right?
Most of these are actually still done in the hospital, but they are done on an outpatient basis.
Okay.
And we're looking at video right here as well. Is there some type of injection here, or what are we looking at?
Essentially, the technique involves placing special needles into the fractured spine, then use of inflatable balloons to bring the spine into a more normal alignment, and then injection of a bone cement to create sort of an internal cast within the bone.
To keep the bone from collapsing again.
Keep the bone from collapsing and reduce the pain that is associated with that fracture.
Now, we know each situation is going to be different for each patient, but for example, doctor, how soon could one actually feel some benefits from this procedure? Does it usually take, you know, several months or several weeks, several days, or what?
Well, of course, every patient is different, but many of our patients see immediate improvement, although many patients will take several days to a few weeks to see the full benefits.
Now, if you have a condition of osteoporosis, this is ongoing, so it doesn't resolve the condition. It basically just treats the result of the condition if you have a fracture. What if you have 2 fractures? Can you do 2 procedures at one time? Since it's so minimally invasive?
Yes, we can do 2 or more fractures at one time.
Wow.
And we can repeat the procedure if a fracture occurs at a different area later.
Does insurance cover it, or Medicare in the case of
Medicare and most insurance companies will cover this procedure.
That's
excellent.
Great. We were also pointing out earlier, it seems, doctor, that Memphis is kind of on the cutting edge when it comes to this procedure. Are we?
Yes, Memphis has always been a cutting edge for orthopedic type of procedures,
right,
which is this an offshoot.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been at the Memphis Vascular Center, been providing this coverage for about 5 years. And this is really a new technique that is becoming more popularized because of such of the great benefits it has for the patient.
Now, we talked about the prevailing audience that needs this is older, but cancer patients following treatment sometimes have spinal fractures caused by weakening of the bones.
That's our second most common reason for doing this procedure is collapse related to cancer. And in some cases, those patients are not able to continue with their therapy because of the pain they're in, and we can help them get back into improve their lifestyle and get back into treatment if that is what is needed.
Are there any type of preventive procedures, though, doctor, at least early on in life, that maybe a lot of us ought to consider before we get into our 50s, 60s, 70s, or 80s, or whatever?
Well, unfortunately for osteoporosis, there's not much you can do after the first couple decades in life. We just try to slow our loss of our weakening bones over time. And there are things that you can do and talk to your primary care doctor to see whether you're at risk. And there are tests to determine whether you have weakening bones. And those tests can be ordered. They're simple tests that can be done through your doctor, primary care doctor.
Yeah, but if you have someone, children, teenagers, go ahead and try to do what you can then to build up that
bone. Well, of course, the drinking vitamin D and calcium intake improves that. And there are some, later in life, there are some medications that may help to slow the process for those people who are at risk.
But for those who don't slow the process enough and have this problem, sounds like kyphoplasty is the answer.
It is. It's been a big help to a lot of patients in this area.
All right. Dr. Jim Bowles with Memphis Vascular Center right here in Memphis. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Appreciate you being here.
And that is where you can find the folks at the Memphis Vascular Center if you know someone with this condition.
All right.